Here's a brief overview of how I organize and facilitated the peer review. Hopefully it's not too confusing. I thought a video would be the best way to kind of break it down for you. So this is the homepage for one of my 111 classes, and I've organized it using modules. So it's organized in weeks. So hopefully, like, students get one during week 11, they just go down the line and they go through each assignment or discussion. When they're in week 12, they go down that line. So under this header here, essay number 2, draft submissions and peer review, what students were working on before the break was their draft for essay number 2. So they should already have had, like, a pretty solid draft since their final draft was initially due before spring break let out. But with everything that happened, we didn't get to the part where they submitted their rough drafts. So anyway, they submitted their essay number 2 rough draft in this assignment box. So I created this assignment box especially for this exercise. And so on April 1st, they had a deadline of like 9 o'clock p.m. And what I did was then on April 2nd, the following day really early, I looked to see who submitted essays and I paired them up that way. And then I created some instructions for them to review, and then I actually have the peer review for them in a discussion post. So this is where they actually exchanged papers, and I did a lot of the heavy lifting there. So what I did was I created this discussion post, and the way that I created it as a group discussion is, so I gave it a title, right, and then I posted the instructions, and then I attached the peer review sheet that they were using. And then what I did was that I clicked on this box that says this is a group discussion. And then I made sure that I selected this under this drop-down thing. If I created groups, it'll show me the different groups that I've created. So I created groups for this particular activity. And the way to do that is you go to people, and it shows you everybody in your class, right? And then here in this button where it says group set, you click on that, and that enables the instructor to create groups for their class. So you give it a title, whatever group activity that you want to title it. And then you can either allow students to self-sign up, like for groups, or you can create, and so that means that students themselves sign up for groups. I never really use this one. I've usually created groups manually, so this is what I'm doing. I click there. Or you can have Canvas just randomly create groups. So you would click on here, and then you would just say how many groups you would want. So because I have, what, like 20 students here, let's say I wanted each group to have about 3 students, then I would create probably 7 groups, right? And so then Canvas would create groups of 3. So they would be grouped into 7 different groups, and each group would have about 3 students. But for this one, I don't want them to randomly be broken up into groups. I want to create the groups, so that's why I clicked on that one. And then it created this for me. So when I first was on this page, it had all of my class here, and then it just said groups, and then I had to like title each group, or I had to add each group. So what you do is you click on this button, add group, and then that's where I was able to create group 1. And let me show you what it looks like. So it's like group 1, so let me create one group, group 9. And then I would limit it to to two people because I want just two people in this activity. And here, whoever's left are the people that didn't submit in a rough draft. So what I'll do is I'll just can just move the students to the groups. And so I'll just move that person and that person. So now those two students are in group 9. And then if you click on group 9, I think it shows you the students. Yeah. So right now it doesn't show me students. And then if you wanna just like move them around, I think it lets you. Yeah, so I could just move them around. And I'm playing around with these because these students, I don't think, are going to submit in group 8 and group 9. I don't think they're going to submit a paper, so I'm able to play around with them. I'm not going to play around with these because they're already set and they have already been grouped. Okay, so now once I have everybody grouped, I have a title for my group, then I can go back to that discussion post. And then it'll show it like this. These are all the groups that are created. So when students see this, they can only access their group. So for example, let me go to group 4. So this is where I did a lot of the heavy lifting, like I say. So here in group 4, one student named Fred Number and another student named William were grouped together. And so what I had to do was I had to post their rough drafts. So in that other discussion, in that other assignment box that I said students submitted their rough drafts, and I checked it in the morning and I saw who submitted something, then I downloaded all those drafts to my desktop, and then I took the time to like go to each group. So here when I was in group 4, I had to find their numbers draft and Will's draft and attach it to this discussion post. And how I did that was I went to reply and I can attach. So I then just put attach this Beth Nambo's rough draft and then attached his rough draft and then attached Will's. And then that's what the students see. So now here I can see that Will already did Beth Nambo's and he posted it up here. And that's what the instructions tell students. I also created a video that walks students through this process. So basically in the video, I just tell them, download this peer review. You need to download your partner's draft and then answer the questions on the peer review, fill out the peer review, then save the peer review to your desktop, and then upload it to this discussion post. And that's what Will did, right? He downloaded the numbers. He downloaded the peer review sheet, that's right here, and then he filled out the peer review sheet, and then he attached it here. And the idea is that Fernando will download this peer review sheet, read it, and then revise. Now, I'm going to share my peer review sheet with you, but one page of the peer review sheet asks students to respond to something that their partner said, and that way I can kind of ensure that students have read each other's comments. In this class, I'm not pleased with the amount of people that have responded to each other. So like for example, Will already responded to Fredman, but Fredman hasn't responded to Will, and I was worried that that might happen. So we'll see if maybe this weekend students will respond. They were actually due today, but the assignment thing doesn't close until Sunday. So I'm hoping that students saw that due date and then just said, okay, I'm just going to wait until Sunday. But I'm not sure. Let's see. Let me go back to modules to see if I missed anything. So students, just to recap, so students submitted their drafts here to essay number two rough draft assignment. The assignment box that I created. I gave them instructions for the peer review. It's basically the instructions I have on the discussion post. And then I'll share this video with you, but this is basically where I walk students through that. Through that process. And then they need to submit their final draft, and then they're going to submit their completed peer review. So the peer review has two parts. So this is the peer review sheet that's a 4-page peer review for them. So I try to be as clear as possible, so I tell them what to do, like with their partner's document. Then I ask them to write down the major claims that the essay is making. And then I ask them to look to see how each paragraph transitions to the other, and then I wanted to look at the scholarly research that was included in the essay. So basically they were just looking for that, were claims being made, and the way that I have it numerically ordered, I wanted them to like visually see, okay, this is the first claim that they're making, how does it transition to the second claim, how does it transition to the third claim. So I wanted them to be able to explain to me, do they see any gaps in how the argument is progressing, or do they see that it flows smoothly? And then in those body paragraphs, what kind of scholarly research did they include? Because this essay, they're looking at alternative viewpoints, and they're working with the same topic that they worked with in essay one. But in essay one, they didn't need to include source material. Essay two, they are including source material. And I wanted the evaluation to share with them how effectively they engaged with that source material. And then here, the writer now needs to like review everything that the peer reviewer said. And then the writer is going to talk about their quoted material. Why is their quote or source material important, and how does that source material connect back to their main idea? And this is just a small exercise that I hope forces students to read the peer review, and that way they can be able to see what the reader saw in their evaluation of the work of the essay, and then have the writer themselves figure out, am I using my scholarly sources effectively? So that's basically how I conducted the peer review, and that's how I conducted in class too. And the first time around when we did it face to face in class, I felt it was pretty successful. I got positive feedback from students. I think that it went smoothly. Like, I felt like I did a lot of the facilitating, and it's been the smoothest that it's ever gone on my end when I've shared instructions with students. But like I said, I'm concerned because not a lot of students have posted their peer review, so I don't understand what's going on there. But let me know if there's anything that you need clarification with, or if I can help you set it up in any way. I think for my 110 class though, They're going to submit an essay soon. I think I'm just going to have them do a self-review. So kind of like what I'm asking the students to do here in that fourth page where they're looking at their own work. I feel more comfortable having my 1-10 students look at their own work because I think this process of downloading documents and uploading documents, I think it's going to be too complicated. It's already it seemed a little bit too much for my 1-1, even though I felt like the instructions were good. Alright, like I said, I'll post the other 2 files for you to preview in case you ever want to use this now or try it out now, or if you want to try it out.